Today, here at Satori Graphics, you're going to learn how to make a flat poster design in Adobe Illustrator. In the description below is a link to the final poster design and a mock-up that you can use for your very own flat poster design. Also, there's a quick Illustrator tip at the very end of the video in relation to Illustrator brushes. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. Before we get into today's flat poster design tutorial, I would like to ask you guys if you think it's a good idea to review your designs one episode per week. If you would all like that, let me know in the comment section below and we can arrange that here at Satori Graphics. So like I said, the final design is linked in the description below for you to download. But for a flat poster design, we're going to be using an A3 document with a 3mm bleed. And of course, it needs to be CMYK for print. I'm using a light blue for my background, but you can use whatever color you want for your flat poster design. Using the rectangle tool, create a shape that covers the entire canvas. We can then lock it in place so it doesn't move around throughout the entire flat poster design tutorial. Choose a shade of very dark blue that is close enough to black but not quite jet black, and then take the rounded rectangle tool. Click once on the canvas and then type in 7mm for the corners. Repeat this once again but with a white rectangle and lay it over the top. And then you need to take the pipette tool and sample the background color. Make a third rounded rectangle, but this time with the smaller round corners, and then place it in position like so. At this juncture, select the white shape and press Command or Control C to copy it. Then select all three shapes and then align them like so to make sure they're positioned perfectly. Open the Pathfinder window and hold down Shift and click both the blue shape and the white shape, and then use this function here in the Pathfinder panel. If you then press Command or Control F, it will paste the shape back into the correct place. And then select both the black shape and the blue shape and repeat the process. Finally, send the black shape backwards once. Now your tape cassette shape has the midsection cut out. Just to demonstrate something quickly, I've made this midsection too wide. Even though it's been cut into the shape, we can still use the Direct Selection tool to edit the shape. Hold down Shift and then select multiple anchor points at once and nudge them over with the arrow keys on your keyboard. Next, open up the Appearance panel and use the Pipette tool to sample the background color once again. We will now make the tape section for our flat poster design. Make a perfect circle with the ellipse tool, and then in the appearance panel, add a new stroke. Drag the stroke to the bottom of the layers and add a white color. I'm going to use 20 as a stroke thickness. Add a second stroke and make it black, but increase the stroke weight quite a bit. Then hold down the Alt Option key and duplicate the circle, and adjust the black stroke so it gives an illusion of a tape inside the cassette for our flat poster design. Select all of the shapes on the actual canvas and bring them to the front of all the layers. Then we need to align the circles along a horizontal plane and place them within the cutout section. select the black shape and then select off of it. We want a slightly lighter shade of dark grey blue so that we can create a small rectangle with the rectangle tool. Using direct selection tool, we can then nudge the top anchor points over like I'm doing here. We then need to place the shape over the cassette tape perfectly in place. By holding down Shift, select both circles and then group them together with Command or Control G. Select everything on your flat poster design and align them like so. We're almost finished with today's tutorial on how to make a flat poster design, so stick around for the finishing touches. And then at the very end of the video, an Illustrator bonus tip based around brushes. With a dull shade of black, create a circle in the top left of the cassette and then duplicate it with the Alt Option key. We then need to make two more circles and then add a yellow color to them. Using Shift, select all four circles, group them together, then duplicate the group and reflect them by placing them in the perfect position on your flat poster design. This next step is a bit fiddly, but it's fairly simple. Make a yellow rectangle like so, and then duplicate it and turn that second rectangle to black. Take your time to make sure that they're perfectly aligned right up to the edge of the white section. We will need the Pathfinder window open for the next part. We then need to select the white shape and copy it with Command or Control C. Select the white shape and the yellow rectangle and use the intersect function in the Pathfinder. Press Command or Control F to paste the shape back, and then send it back one layer. Repeat the process with the back rectangle, and then send the white shape back twice. There is a shortcut on your keyboard for this function if you see here. We will now add a shadow to our flat poster design, so group every single element on the cassette tape together, and then place it exactly where you want it on your poster design. Using the pen tool, make a line from the bottom left of the tape to the bottom right of the canvas. Click off of the path, and then make another line from the top right of the tape downwards. Flick the path over to a fill, and then bring the cassette tape to the front. Now this part is entirely up to you, but you can add a gradient and lower the opacity of that gradient, or you can simply lower the opacity of the shape without the gradient. Whatever you think looks best for your flat poster design. To save time, I've gone ahead and added the typographic elements on the design. And to be honest, this section of the tutorial should be up to you, so get creative with your typography. I do have the design linked in the description below for you to download, as well as the mock-up for Photoshop. Next, a quick but cool tip on Illustrator brushes. There are some really neat and cool brushes by default in Adobe Illustrator. So open up the brush libraries, like so, and then choose from a nice selection. If you then double click a brush, you can edit it. You can change the pressure and the style, the direction, and other various factors. There are actually quite a decent amount of free brushes here, as standard in Adobe Illustrator. You can then go ahead and add them to your design. You can outline the stroke of the brush, and then have a fully customizable vector brush on your design. So if you enjoyed today's tutorial on how to make a flat poster design in Adobe Illustrator, drop a like and a comment on this video, as well as share it on social media. Spread the word of Satori because it does help my channel grow. Remember to subscribe for weekly graphic design uploads if you haven't done already. And until next time, design your future today. Peace.